welcome back to Proactive Investors. Joining me now from Buru Energy is CEO Thomas Nador. Thomas, welcome to the program. Glad to have you here.
It's great to be here.
Thomas, some news out from your Rafael gas and condensate discovery today. Tell us all about what is happening over at the project.
Okay, look, it's been a busy 2 months since we announced that Buru is acquiring Origin's Canning Basin joint venture interests. At the time, we spoke of the strategic value of the deal and the autonomy and the flexibility it provides Buru to get after the Rafael development. We are now very much demonstrating that value and building momentum. We've submitted a declaration of location application to the government of our now 100% owned Rafael discovery, which has been independently assessed to have the potential recoverable volumes of over 1 trillion cubic feet of gas and over 20 million barrels of condensate. Submitting a declaration of location is the next step on the way to a production license for the project. So once approved, we will have 2 years with an option to extend by another 2 years to apply for a production license required to develop the field. We've also just completed a pre-feasibility study for a regionally located floating LNG concept as an option to develop the resource. The four-month study, which we carried out in collaboration with Transborders Energy and Technip Energies out of Paris, demonstrated that a Kimberley-based 1.6 million tonne per annum floating LNG facility with onshore condensate and LPG processing is technically, commercially, and economically feasible and provides a credible option for us to develop a 3C contingent resource. Based on this work, we concluded that this option definitely merits further investigation, not only because of its technical feasibility at this stage of definition, but also the strategic value of potentially leveraging Transborder's collaborative agreement with LNG buyers, LNG shippers, engineers, constructors, and investors, all with the common goal of bringing resource developments like Rafael to life.
So plenty happening here in the Canning Basin. Thomas, I just want to get down to brass tacks and really confirm here. Does all of this mean that Rafael will be developed by a floating LNG solution?
Not necessarily. This is part of us casting quite a wide net of engineering and commercial solutions to develop Rafael based on a range of resource sizes. The FLNG concept addresses our 3C contingent volumes, but we are investigating projects for a full range of resource sizes, which will be confirmed through future appraisal. This is a very cost-effective way to be ready to move forward on a selected project once appraisal outcomes are known later next year. We are studying a range of projects from local, smaller-scale LNG for Kimberley Power to local downstream projects that add value to gas by converting to products like methanol, ammonia, and urea. Importantly, all of these projects could also benefit from carbon capture and storage solutions that we are also developing by our GeoVault subsidiary.
So Thomas, it sounds like there's plenty happening on the ground here. Now, obviously, this asset is a feather in your cap, but there is plenty happening across the portfolio. Tell us, when can investors expect to hear more about this work?
We are targeting completing these studies to the same level of definition as the floating LNG option by June this year. So we are very busy on the engineering and commercial front to bring it all together and provide certainty to the market around our commercialization options and roadmaps going forward.
And you mentioned an appraisal before. Tell us, what are your latest plans to appraise the Rafael asset?
The Rafael appraisal program has been kicked off already. It's ongoing. We are mapping the reprocessed 2D seismic data to give us further insights on potential Rafael resource volumes. But we are also on track to carry out a 3D seismic survey over the Rafael structure in the second half of this year, which will also inform our appraisal drilling program that we are targeting for 2024. So I really look forward to updating your viewers on what is a very exciting time at Buru.
Buru Energy CEO Thomas Nador, we appreciate you bringing us up to speed on all things Rafael and all across your portfolio. We look forward to the next update. Thanks for your time.
Thank you so much.